In this video, we will see about Biot-Savart law, Ampere-Circuit law, Faraday's law and pointing vector. And we will see about Maxwell equation in next video. So this Biot-Savart law, is used to determine the magnetic field intensity due to constant current carrying element. If you are consider, this is the current carrying element. And this is a direction of current, and this is total length L. And if you are taking any differential length, that is, this is dl, and this current carrying element generate the magnetic field around this element. And if you are considering any point, if you consider the point P, and this law is used to find the amount of magnetic field intensity in this point using some formula. So the Biot-Savart law state that the magnetic flux intensity H is directly proportional to the current and magnitude of this differential length of this element. And if you connect this and the angle between this P and the line joining this P and this dl, the angle between these two, that will given as a sine theta, and divided by the, this considered as r, the square of this distance between this P and this dl. So this is the Biot-Savart law. And if you are equaling, this is h is equal to k I dl sine theta divided by r square. If k is equal to 1 by 4 pi, this h become I dl sin theta divided by 4 pi r square. So from that equation, we can tell that the P point is perpendicular this to this dl. So the theta is 90 and sin 90 is 1. So the magnetic field is maximum in that point. So this is a Biot-Savart law, and we can use this law to find the amount of magnetic field intensity. So next we will see about the Ampere-Circuit law, and this law state that the magnetic flux intensity in any closed path that is equal to the current enclosed by that path, and this is known as Ampere-Circuit law. That means the magnetic flux intensity in any closed path, that L, that is equal to the current enclosed, current carried by that closed path. Next we will see about the Faraday's law, and this law states that the induced EMF in volts, that is equal to the time rate of change of magnetic flux linked by that circuit. And here this N is the number of turns, and this psi is the flux through each turn. And this negative term means that this induced EMF is opposite to its direction to that flux. Next we see about the pointing vector, and this pointing vector is the cross product of electric field intensity and magnetic field intensity. So this is known as pointing vector. And this is known as pointing theorem. This is pointing theorem. And this pointing theorem states that the total power leaving the volume, that is equal to the rate of decrease in energy stored in electric and magnetic field minus that ohmic losses. And this is known as pointing theorem. And in our next video, we derive the Maxwell equation, and we solve the problem related to this magnetic field topic. Thank you.